I'm Stephanie Liu, and I'm here today with Leslie Hawthorn from the open source team. And they just announced something very exciting last week. You want to tell us about it?
Sure, absolutely. So last week we kicked off the Google Summer of Code program for 2009. So this is our fifth year of running the program, so it's really exciting to hit that milestone. And we started accepting applications from open source projects who wanted to act as mentors for various students throughout the world to work on their respective code bases. And yesterday was also a really cool day. We announced the list of accepted organizations for 2009. So we'll be working with 150 free and open source software projects to mentor our students this year, which is pretty groovy.
Do you want to tell us a little bit of the history, kind of like behind the program? Like,
sure,
why
totally.
We do this?
So back in 2005, Larry Page, one of our co-founders, was thinking about kind of an age-old problem, which is, you know, students go to school, they work really, really hard during the term, and then over the summer they go off and do various assorted things, and you know, what happens? Their knowledge of their discipline atrophies. And you know, he was thinking particularly in terms of computer science, right? And looking at sort of the experience levels of different folks who are coming in through Google, and also what he was hearing from other folks in industry, and finding, you know, a lot of computer science graduates students weren't actually able to find jobs in computer science or technical fields during their summer holidays. And you know, hey, here's open source, right? Open source is completely distributed. You can work on it from, you know, the comfort of your own living room or your local internet cafe. It doesn't require a specific job opening to be available to you, but hey, if Google provides stipends to these students who are working on open source projects, they have kind of an externship in their chosen field, and they get the opportunity not only to have a job in a technical field, but to learn about real-world software development scenarios, right? So things like using version control or working in a distributed team where, you know, some of the developers are in, say, London and some in Beijing and some in Sydney.
That's definitely important at Google with distributed teams.
Oh, yeah.
It's much more challenging than you would think at first.
So the thing I tell students who are looking to apply to the program is, well, number one, don't be intimidated. I hear over and over and over again that, you know, folks are, you know, they think summer code is exciting, they really like the idea of participating in open source, and you know, but they're scared to death because they think it's really competitive and it's really hard to get in, and they're not smart enough, or they don't have a, you know, rigorous enough background. And you know, that's just not the case. We have a wide variety of projects from a wide variety of technical disciplines working with us each year. Some projects are looking for people who have almost no experience in computer science. Some of the projects are looking for folks who are more advanced and maybe doing, you know, post-grad research, for example. So there's really something for everybody. And one of my favorite examples to cite here is a gal by the name of Angela Byron. She was a student in the very first Summer of Code in 2005. And when Angie started off working with the Drupal project, she had never worked on an open source project before. She was a community college student. And she took a look at the Summer of Code and thought, well, it's for students, right? So they have to be looking for beginners. So this whole open source thing, you know, I could do it too. And she got involved with Drupal. Now she's one of the biggest advocates for the Drupal project. And you know, 4+ years later, she is the maintainer for Drupal 7, which is the latest release of Drupal. She's on the board of directors for the Drupal Association. So do not be intimidated. Even if you are an absolute beginner, this is still something that's completely accessible to you. And if you're not an absolute beginner, again, it's accessible. You just have to be willing to take a risk, put it out there, and apply. The worst that you can do is not get accepted and continue to be excited about a particular open source project. Keep working with them, keep learning more about their code base, keep submitting patches or writing documentation or doing whatever really excites you. And then, you know, who knows what the future will hold in terms of your opportunity to work with that organization in like a future Summer of Code if we do one again, or to get a job in that particular field, right?
So what are the, let's talk stats a little bit, like how many applicants do we usually get? How many people will actually get accepted?
So last year we had a little over 3,000 applicants, and we had a total of about 7,000 applications, and we actually accepted just under 1,200 students. So, you know, about a third of our participants actually, you know, joined the program. So it's competitive, but it's not as competitive as a lot of grant programs. And we do allow students to apply to multiple different projects. So let's say you're equally excited about kernel hacking and open source games. So if you wanted to submit an application to, say, the Linux Foundation to work on the kernel, you could do that. And you could also submit an application to work with, say, the 1000 Parsec project on their turn-based strategy game. That's totally cool. You have up to 20 applications, so you could submit all 20 to one organization or 20 to 20 different ones if you want to. But Another tidbit of advice for students who are thinking about applying to Summer of Code, spend your time concentrating on just a couple of applications, something that you're truly passionate about, something that's really exciting to you, because quality is better than quantity. We hear that universally from our mentors. So again, find your passion, scratch your own itch. It's what's exciting and compelling to you. And that passion and desire to improve things is really gonna show through when you're talking to your potential mentors.
So what are mentors, what are organizations, and what are we looking for when we're looking through, looking through these applications?
For mentoring, a mentoring organization is any group who is working on a free and open source software project or technology project that again results in the production of open source code. And the organizations that have participated both in past years and this year's are working on a hugely wide variety of technical areas. I mean, you've got folks who are working on, media player software. You have folks who are doing content management systems so that you can design, websites using their software. We've got folks who are working on the Linux kernel and kernel drivers. We've got folks who are working on, creating open source games. We have folks who are working on, open source CAD and automation software. There's really a little bit of something for everybody, right? And one of the reasons why we select so many different types of projects is we want students who, have a wide variety of interests to come in and start participating in open source development. In terms of what we look for in the organizations that we accept, there's a whole wide variety of factors. And actually, if there are projects who are interested in learning more about that, there's actually a full document produced on our website that'll tell you a little bit more about our selection criteria. So if you're interested in the future, that would be a useful resource for you. So other advice that I would give to student participants who want to get involved in Summer of Code and just open source in general is do not wait for Summer of Code to start to get involved with an open source project or to get involved in open source, because Summer of Code kicks off for the year and all the folks who are interested in a particular project who are really invested in that community, they get really, really busy. And if they've only gotten to know you in the last week versus someone who's been hanging around a long time and contributing a few patches, answering questions on a mailing list, hanging out in the IRC channel fielding questions, they're going to be that much more likely to want to accept that particular person. And it's not necessarily because they have prior open source experience or that they have more knowledge about the project exactly. It's more about they've already seen that that person is willing to make an investment in the community. There's so many good stories.
I like stories.
I know, I like stories too. Well, okay, so, I just want to go on record as saying I hate this part, because I always feel like every single one of our students who finishes is their own success story, and unfortunately, now we've got, 2,400 students who've completed the program, and I think I know maybe 350 of the success stories, and I really should know them all. So a couple of really cool ones, I've already mentioned Angie's story. We have a gal by the name of Joanna Trinidad who is in Brazil, and she worked with the Globus Alliance. They're a group of folks who are working on grid computing technologies. She worked on some single sign-on software for them last year, and as a result of her Summer of Code project, she was invited to be a visiting researcher at the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. So, and we hear from students all the time, I got my dream job because of being in Summer of Code, or I was hired to work at this software consultancy shop because of my Summer of Code project, and it was my mentor's business, and I did so well that he wants to hire me. So there's lots of cool stuff like that. Other cool stuff, like you may have seen, I'm sure everyone's seen the Matrix movies. One of our Summer of Code students.
Oh, that little thing?
Yeah, take the red pill, man. One of our students, Adriano Montero Marquez, one year, he did a whole graphical user interface front end for Nmap security scanner that was in the Matrix. So I think one of the coolest projects right now that I'm thinking about for Summer of Code is actually Melange. And Melange is the code base that's going to run the Summer of Code program from here on out. And it's the first open source project that was developed at Google in the open with community input from commit number one. And it was a result of a couple of things. One, we've got a community of over 2,500 mentors and 2,400 student participants from past years. And, clearly, that's going to be more people than Google is ever going to be able to devote to doing engineering work for Summer of Code, right? And also, we've had people come to us over and over again saying, hey, we love Summer of Code. We love the model. We want to do our own Summer of Code-like program. Can we use your infrastructure? And since the infrastructure was all tied into Google backend technologies, we weren't able to do that. But now anybody can take this code, run with it, plug it into whatever database backend they want. Our instance is running on Google App Engine, for example. And, you know, make this program their own, make this model their own. And a lot of folks have already done that, right? We've got like the Finnish folks have done a summer of code. We had a New Zealand summer of code. There was a season of usability for students to work on usability issues in open source software. Like the GNOME folks last year did an accessibility outreach summer of code like thing. So, you know, we're watching this meme spread. And now I'm really excited about the fact that not only is the model spreading, but now we're actually able to provide to the community an infrastructure to grow that model and to, you know, to make it happen on your own. So that's really, really groovy.
That's really cool.
And even cooler, not that I'm not, you know, totally biased and excited about this, is the committer team for the Melange project. We actually handed over project management to the community back in January, and our project leader is actually a former Summer of Code student. Pavel Soya. So he was a Summer of Code student for 2 years, then he went on to become a mentor for the Natural User Interface Group in 2008, and now in 2009 he's, you know, he's the project lead for the infrastructure that's actually making the program happen. Please visit code.google.com/SOC for Summer of Code. And if you would like regular program updates, but you're not necessarily ready to apply for Summer of Code just yet, you can check out all the news you can use on the Google Open Source blog, which is google-opensource, all one word, .blogspot.com. So come on over, hang out on our blog, feel the love with us. It's a beautiful thing.
Cool. Thanks, Leslie.
Thank you.